Praise the Lord. Somebody there said, praise the Lord. Divine connection. For me. For you. And for all. The Lord will do it in your life in Jesus' name. All our brethren, all men, women, children, young people, everywhere, as we connect with the Lord tonight, something spectacular will happen in your life. Unprecedented miracle. And all our brothers and sisters, men and women online, my heart comes to you specially. And as we pray and as we preach, I have you in mind right there in your home. Anywhere you are, power, amen. Divine operation, amen. Miracle, amen. The spectacular will happen in every life in Jesus' name. Amen. Why don't we pray together? Father, we thank you for this hour. We thank you for this moment. And we're asking, oh Lord, you will do the spectacular supernatural in every life tonight in Jesus' name. Amen. Save those who are struggling with their sin. Amen. Restore those who are backsliding. Amen. And strengthen the believers. And every miracle of healing, of deliverance we need, we pray you provide for everyone and touch every life in Jesus' name. Amen. We count it done. Amen. And we're going to testify. Amen. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Another amen before you settle down. Amen. God bless you. We're coming to Genesis chapter 1, and I'm reading from verse 26. Genesis chapter 1, we're reading from verse 26. And God said, let us make man in our image, after our likeness, and let them have dominion over the fish of the sea, and over the fowl of the air, and over the cattle, and over all the earth, and over every creeping thing that creepeth upon the earth. Look at verse 27 there. It says, so God created man in his own image. In the image of God created he him. Male and female created he them. That's the God of creation, the God of all authority, and the God of all power. He created man. And then he tells us how man will be, how man will live, and he wanted that to continue in every generation. He actually wanted man, woman, you and I, to live on the supernatural power. Tonight, I'm talking to you on super living through divine connection. He wants us to live in such a way that we're above every problem, above all sin, above all sicknesses, above all the powers and all the affliction of the enemy. And that's what he's bringing us to in this time of divine connection. The topic again, super living through divine connection. We're looking at Psalm 8, and I'm reading from verse 4. Psalm 8, verse 4. What is man that thou art mindful of him, or the son of man that thou visitest him? Then he tells us in verse 5 what the man should look like, how the man should live, and the power and the authority and the possibilities and the life of every man. Look at verse 5. For thou hast made him a little lower than the angels. When you see what God has done, the plan of God, the purpose of God, and the project God had for man, for you and for me, he wanted us just a little bit lower than the angels. And you can begin to think about the life of the angels And you can begin to think about the power, the authority that abides in the angels. You can begin to think about the freedom of those angels. And then it tells us, thou hast made him, God has made man, the creator has made man just a little bit lower than the angels, and has crowned him with glory and honor. That glory is coming back. That honor is coming back. And everything that brings disgrace or shame or weakness or suffering or affliction or habitual sinning in the life of anyone, the Lord is going to cleanse you. It's going to change you. And the glorious life and the gracious life and the happy life and the victorious life that he has determined for you and for me and for everyone, that glorious life, gracious life, godly life will come upon every life in Jesus' name. And then it says in verse 6, thou makest him to have dominion. You'll have dominion. You'll have power. You'll have authority. And you will live a life of victory and triumph in Jesus' name. Thou makest him to have dominion over the works of thy hands. Thou hast put all things under his feet. All things under my feet. Calamity under my feet. Suffering under my feet. I thought you say it for yourself. Sickness under your feet. And all the oppression that goes on in the world under your feet in Jesus' name. Look at that, look at that. Thou hast put all things under his feet. They will come under your feet by divine connection. That's what we're talking about, super living through divine connection. There are three things we're looking at before we pray, and the prayer today will touch your life. The prayer today will change your life. It will turn everything around in your life in Jesus' name. Three things. Number one, connection. Number two, disconnection. Number three, reconnection. You see, when God made man originally, there was divine connection. But then, because of the fall of man, there came a disconnection. And then the Lord said, it will not remain like that. And he sent Jesus Christ on the cross of Calvary, and he died for you, and he died for me, and he died for the whole of humanity. And there was now a reconnection. Three things: connection, two, disconnection, and then three, reconnection. Number one, unlimited connection. When God made Adam and Eve, he gave them connection. He said, let us make man like ourselves. And then they'll have the same dominion, the same power, the same dominion God had in heaven, they will have over here on earth. And the same power, the same authority that God had in heaven, they will have over here on earth. Unlimited connection. But then, because of sin, because of disobeying the Lord and taking what the Lord had told them not to take, there was a universal disconnection. The whole of earth and all the descendants of Adam and Eve and all their children, they were disconnected. And then to the present day, there is that universal disconnection. But then Christ has come. And as Christ came, he died on the cross of Calvary to take your sin away, and then to make you come in fellowship with God again. And now we have a unique reconnection. Unique in the sense that although it's for everybody, he died for everyone. For God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten son, that whosoever, who is that whosoever there tonight? That whosoever believeth in him will not perish. You will not perish. I said you will not perish. will not perish but have everlasting life. But it is whosoever believeth on him. That makes it unique. It means it's not just like everybody. You must be willing, you must be repentant, and you must totally and personally, wholeheartedly give yourself to the Lord. And then as you do that uniquely by yourself, then the unique connection, reconnection will take part, it will take place again, a unique reconnection. Three things. Number one, the plenitude of unlimited connection. The plenitude, that the fullness, that the flowing, that the extreme, that the totality of the unlimited connection. Number one, the plenitude of unlimited connection. Number two, the problem of universal disconnection, the perplexity of universal disconnection. Number three, now the possibilities. All things are possible tonight. In your life, all things are possible. In your body, all things are possible. In your spirit, in your soul, all things are possible. Something is going to happen to you. What am I talking about? It will happen in Jesus' name. The possibilities in a unique reconnection. Let's come to number one. Number one, we're looking at the plenitude of unlimited connection. As we look at Psalm 145, reading from verse 9, Psalm 145, verse 9, the Lord is good to all, and his tender mercies are over all his works. When God created man, he created man in such a way that all the goodness of heaven, all the goodness of his heart, all the goodness of, that he had, that he could shower on man, he made everything available. And that original divine connection provided unlimited benefits, unlimited benefits. As you look at Adam and you look at Eve, and as you look at them together, and as you look at them in the garden of Eden, no sin, no sickness, no suffering. That's how God made them. And that's how God wants everything to continue in your life, in my life. No sin, give me a good amen. No sickness, another amen. And no suffering. When he brings you back to the original plan, that's what will happen. Not only that, there was no discord, there was no disappointment, and there was no disloyalty. As you look at Adam and Eve, as they were living together in the garden of Eden, in the garden of pleasure, in the garden of bliss, in the garden of the supernatural protection, you find that between them, no discord, no disappointment, and no disloyalty. It was their sinning that brought all those things back to their lives. And when Christ comes into your life, all disappointment will vanish away. In my life, in my life, in my life, all disappointment will vanish away in Jesus' name. You remember when the Lord created Adam and Eve, and he said, let us make man in our image, after our likeness. There was no curse, there was no cruelty, and there was no contention. And the curse that came was because of their sinning, was because of their departing from the Lord. And now that Christ has come, if you receive Christ into your heart tonight, if you say, come in, because he says, I'm knocking at the door, and anyone that opens the door, I will come in. He will come to everyone today. I see him, I see you opening the door and saying, Lord, come in. Lord Jesus, come in. And then every curse in your life, praise the Lord, is broken tonight in Jesus' name. Do you know that when God created Adam and Eve, for them, there was no danger, and there was no demon for them, and there was no death, that is, but he told them, any day you touch that thing, any day you eat the forbidden fruit, then you will die. There was life, abundant life. There was life, a beautiful life, but it was the sin that brought the danger. But originally, no danger. What do you think about that? If God will bring you to himself and reconnect you with himself, and then no disaster in your life. No danger in your life. And no demons can hover around you, because originally, when there was divine connection, there was no problem with any demon. And all those demons that cause affliction, as you reconnect with the Lord today, I want to assure you, demons will vanish away. And all those demonic afflictions, everything will vanish away in Jesus' name. Do you know that there was no fraud, there was no falsehood, and there was no fear when the Lord created Adam and Eve? I'm showing you that that was the result of the original divine connection. And when that divine connection takes place today, all the fears of your life, they are canceled. And all fraud, they are canceled in Jesus' name. There was no greed, there was no gambling, and there was no guilt. It is a falling away that has brought greed, that has brought gambling, and has brought guilt in the lives of many people. But thank God today, divine connection. Somebody shout, divine connection. That divine connection will take all the greed away, and will take all the guilt away from your life in Jesus' name. How do you want to live without malice, without mischief, without mistreatment? You know, some people crying, I'm being mistreated. They take me like a slave in my master's house. Even in my father's house, they take me like a slave. Everybody mistreats me and they reject me. Originally, when God created Adam and Eve, and that divine connection was there, the unlimited result of that divine connection is that there was no malice, and there was no mischief, and there was no mistreatment, and that is coming back. That every mistreatment in your life, the Lord will wipe that away. He'll wipe your tears away. You'll never be the same again in Jesus' name. You know what happened at that time? At that time when the Lord created Adam and Eve, and there was that divine connection, they had only peace. Peace is coming back. They had pleasantness. Pleasantness is coming back in your life. They had purity. Purity. Heaven's purity coming upon them. That heaven's purity is coming upon your life in Jesus' name. They had purposefulness. You see, there are people, they have talent, but there's no purpose. They have gift, there's no purpose. They have skill, there is no purpose. And they do not channel all those things the Lord has given to purposeful living. But you see, for Adam and Eve, in that original stage of mind, when God created them, they had all this in their lives, and they had progress. You are going to have progress. The past thing, disappointment, and the past defeat, and the past serious case of, you know, walking and walking and walking and no progress, all that is going to pass away. And they had partnership with God. Partnership with God. That's why he will come in the cool of the day and say, Adam, where are you? He had fellowship with them. Anything that ought to be fixed up, he fixed everything. Profitability was there. You will be profitable. And they had patience. You don't have any fighting between Adam and Eve when there was that divine connection. And as that divine connection comes upon your life, there will be a patience in your life with one another in the family in Jesus' name. And you know, as you look at them, there is princeliness, the lead, of course, like somebody having dominion, of course, like a prince, of course, like a king. And because of that, there was princeliness, the way they conducted themselves and the way they carried themselves and the way they lived and the provisions they had and everything. You saw them, and all the spirit world can see, there was princeliness in their lives. And then their lives were just for the praise of God, for the glory of God. They were made so that they will praise the Lord. And your life from today, as you have this divine connection, as the Lord gets us back into reconnection, the Lord himself will make your life a praise, your family a praise. I will make your surrounding a praise, and everything will be praiseworthy in your life in Jesus' name. Actually, that Garden of Eden for them was like paradise, a taste of heaven on earth. Paradise, a taste of heaven on earth. And that is what he wants to bring us to. There is that original connection, divine connection, that gave them all these unlimited possibilities. Look at that again in Psalm 145, reading from verse 9. The Lord is good to all. That's the nature of God. He wanted the same thing and the same privilege he made for Adam and Eve. He wanted that same thing in the life of everyone. And the Lord is, not that the Lord was in the past and is no more doing that, not that the Lord will be in the future, in the millennium, and is not doing it now, at the present time, even today, on this first day of divine connection, the Lord will be good to you. Is good to all. He opens the eyes of the blind. Is good to all. He makes the lame to walk. Is good unto all. The moment we mention the name of Jesus, who has come to reconnect us with the Heavenly Father, the goodness of the Lord will flow into your life in Jesus' name. Have you heard this verse of scripture before? He went about telling me, doing good and healing how many people? All that were oppressed of the devil, for God was with him. And he never rejected anyone. A leper came, if thou wilt, thou canst make me clean. I will be thou clean. Immediately the goodness of the Lord appeared in his life, and the leprosy was totally clean. And then another woman with the issue of blood, if I may but touch the hem of his garment, I shall be made whole. She came and she touched, and the blood of 12 years, everything vanished away. They were carrying out a man, the only son of this widow, and she was said he was dead. And Jesus saw her weeping and said, weep not. And the Lord is telling you tonight, weep not. Brother, was he telling you tonight, weep not? Sister, was he telling you tonight, weep not? And those online, you are in your room there, and you are watching with us, is telling you something tonight, weep not. All the tears will be wiped away in Jesus' name. And he told them to stop, and then he touched the bier, and he that was dead came up. Because it's good to all. Even the centurion that said, I'm not worthy that you should come under my roof, he said, I'm coming to heal him. No discrimination and no partiality. And tonight there's no discrimination. As the Lord is good to all, he'll be good to you. I said he'll be good to you. That's why you are expecting, as you confess your sin, it will save you. As you turn away from your sin, it will save you. And it will do a recreation and redemption and turning around in your life in Jesus' name. For those who are sinners, he'll be good to you. He will save you. I didn't hear your amen. For those who are sick, it'll be good to you. It will heal you. And for those who are oppressed and depressed, it'll be good to you. It will deliver you. And for those who are living in a local famine, there's nothing to eat and there's nothing to maintain your life, it will be good to you and it will provide for you in Jesus' name. And for those who are crying and for those who say, what kind of life am I living? The Lord is going to be good to you tonight. As we mention the name of Jesus and you reconnect with the Lord will be good to you tonight and he will answer your prayer in Jesus' name. The Lord is good to all and his tender mercies are over. How many of his works? All his works. Everyone created by God, whether you are from that side or from this side, whether you've been in church before or this is your first time of ever connecting with a Christian program, the Lord's mercies, the mercy that saves, the mercy that forgives, and the mercy that sets free, and the mercy that breaks every yoke, the Lord's mercies are over all his works. And he will grant you that tonight in Jesus' name. And look at verse 10. In verse 10, he tells us there, all thy works shall praise thee, O Lord, and thy saints shall bless thee. All your creation, all men, women, boys and girls, having any challenge, having any problem, as the Lord makes a reconnection with you tonight, and he solves your problem, you will praise the Lord. And then he tells us in verse 11, he says, they shall speak of the glory of thy kingdom and talk of thy power. That power is coming. Amen. Connection. Somebody shout connection. That connection will bring the power of the Almighty in your life and you'll talk about it, you'll testify about it. I can almost see you now coming out and then taking the mic and saying, I am the one, I am blessed tonight, I am healed tonight. It will happen in Jesus' name. Look at verse 12. In verse 12, to make known to the sons of men his mighty acts and the glorious majesty of his kingdom. Verse 13 tells us, it says, thy kingdom is an everlasting kingdom, thy dominion endureth throughout all generations. Throughout all generations. And so we're still inside those generations, all generations. There's a reconnection, and because of that reconnection, divine power, divine authority, divine anointing will come upon you, and the hand of the Lord will touch you. You'll never be the same. I will never be the same. Dominion will be upon everyone. Upon me. I said upon me. And a great connection will bring us something good, something wonderful, something spectacular in your life today in Jesus' name. Look at Isaiah chapter 48. Isaiah chapter 48. I'm reading from verse 17 here. It says in Isaiah chapter 48 verse 17. It says, thus says the Lord, thy Redeemer. Thus says the Lord, thy Redeemer. The Lord is your Redeemer. What's the Lord to you tonight? I said, what's the Lord to you tonight? He'll redeem you from sin. Say good amen. He'll redeem you from slavery. Say another amen. He'll redeem you from sickness. Another amen. He'll redeem you from suffering. Another amen. The Lord thy God is thy Redeemer, the Holy One of Israel. I am the Lord thy God, which teacheth thee to profit. Teacheth thee to profit. Profit will come upon your life from tonight. You come before the Lord for divine connection, profit will come. Heavenly profit will come. Your desired prophet will come in Jesus' name. I am the Lord thy God, which teacheth thee to profit. which leadeth thee by the way that thou shouldest go. We don't know where our good is, but God knows where our good is. He will take your hand. He will lead you to the place where your goodness is, in Jesus' name. We don't know where our prosperity is, and we don't know where our satisfaction, our great supply, our sufficient supply, we don't know where it is, but the Lord is saying, He will lead you to that supply. Tonight, all you need is a reconnection with the Lord. And as you are connected with the Lord is telling us He will lead us. And then not only that He will lead us, He will bring us to the place where we should go. And eventually, He will lead you to heaven. I will not go to hell. You will not go to hell. On the basis of divine reconnection with the Lord, He will take your hand, and that place you ought to go, the heavenly city, that place you ought to go eternally, forever and ever, living with the Lord, because of that divine reconnection, He will take you to the heavenly place in Jesus' name. Look at verse 18. In verse 18, it says, "Oh, that thou art hearkened unto my commandments." When it says, "Come and repent," oh, that thou hast hearkened unto my commandments. When it says, "And now break all that sin that brought disconnection in your life and be reconnected with the Lord and be transformed and be changed and have Jesus Christ in your heart and in your life. Oh, that my people had hearkened unto my commandments, then at thy peace being as a river, and thy righteousness at the waves of the sea." Tonight is your night. Why is the man, the woman I'm talking to there? Tonight is your night. That's what He said He will do. And when He said He will do it for Adam and Eve, let's make man in our image and in our likeness. Let them have dominion. What He had decided, He carried out. And all that is deciding now, as we're reconnected with the Lord, He will carry it out in your life. And tonight will be a turning point, a turning around in your life, in Jesus' name. We're coming to point number two now. Point number two is the problem, the perplexity of universal disconnection. The problem of universal disconnection. Look at Genesis chapter 3. I'm reading from verse 1. It says, "Now the serpent was more subtle than any beast of the field which the Lord God had made. And He said unto the woman, Yea, as God said, ye shall not eat of every tree of the garden." And then in verse 2, "The woman said unto the serpent, We may eat of the fruit of the trees of the garden, but," in verse 3, "of the fruit of the tree which is in the midst of the garden, God hath said, Ye shall not eat it, neither shall ye touch it, lest ye die." And then in verse 4, "And the serpent," that's actually Satan, "that comes in the mind, in the body of the serpent." Just like Satan entered into Judas, and just like Satan made some people to say or to do what they do, in this way now, at this place now, the serpent was representing Satan, said unto the woman, "Ye shall not surely die." Of course, you know that Satan, when God has said, if you eat it, you will die, any person, any personality, whether in the spiritual realm or in the physical realm or natural man or natural place that contradicts the Almighty God, you know that is the influence of Satan. And Satan said, "Ye shall not surely die." And then in verse 6, eventually the woman was convinced. And when the woman saw that the tree was good for food, and that it was pleasant to the eyes, and a tree to be desired to make one wise, she took of the fruit thereof and did eat, and also gave unto her husband with her, and he did eat. That the thing that disconnected Adam and Eve from God, that's the thing that disconnected all their children, Cain and Abel, disconnected them from God. That's the thing that has disconnected the whole of humanity from God. Sin came in. Number one, sin caused separation from God. And the word of God makes it very clear. Your sin, your iniquity, your transgression has separated you from me. Not only that, number two, Satan confined sinners to godlessness. They didn't repent, they only gave excuse. You see, when the Lord is saying, I want to show you mercy, I want to forgive you, I want to turn your life around, if you accept and you apologize and you pray and you repent, redemption will come. Salvation will come. The mercy of God will come. But if you give excuse, it's not my fault, the Philistine that made me do that. If you give excuse, thank you very much. If you give excuse for all the things the Lord is saying, where are you? Why have you done this? Why is this taking place in your life? If you give excuse, then Satan will confine such a person to godlessness and to evil and to suffering and to the sickness. But if you say, Lord, I don't have any excuse. I sinned. I did evil. All I'm asking for is mercy. Mercy will reach you there. Forgiveness will reach you there. Salvation will reach you there. And then the result of that thing they did that disconnected them with the Lord, suffering came, was sinning against God. What do you think about all the suffering we have in the world today? All that suffering would not have come except there was a disconnection from the Lord. And today the Lord wants to repair everything that is broken down. And the Lord wants to say, you know why you are suffering? You know what the problem is? It's because of this disconnection. Now come, be reconnected, and I praise God for you. Something good will happen as you reconnect with the Lord today in Jesus' name. Now see what they were thinking. Number one, it's a single sin. And so, only one sin will not matter at all. And then, it was a sweet sin. Take it. You will enjoy it. And they thought, and then Eve shared with Adam. It was a shared sin. They shared it together. And then they said, this couldn't be very serious. It's a small sin. And because they thought like that, that's why they went into what they went into. It's small, it's small. And then a secret, nobody will know this. It's just between you and I. And we do this and everything will be all right. It was a suggested sin. Satan suggested it, and the serpent suggested it and said, why don't you take it? And it's not going to matter at all. In fact, you're going to be more civilized. Your eyes will open. You'll be wise and you'll know good from evil. It's going to be a better thing for you. Satan suggested it. And then there are people today, they are committing similar sins. Satan suggesting to them, sinners suggesting to them, their neighbors suggesting to them, and they go into similar sin. What was the result? Single sin became a disconnecting sin. That single sin reaching out and taking that fruit that the Lord has said thou shalt not take, that single sin became a disconnecting sin. You know, when people do that today and they say, it's only one sin, I'm going to do this and no more, that single sin will disconnect them from God. Number two, sweet sin that they said, this is sweet. That's what something was thinking about when he did what he did. This is sweet. That he said, have you not found another woman in the land of Israel that you are going to this Philistine? Leave me alone. It she pleases me well. This is sweet. And many times when people commit that today and they do something that appears sweet to them, sweet sin became disempowering sin. It disempowered Adam and Eve, and today it disempowers everyone. If you are secretly committing sin, you say it's only a single sin, it will disconnect you from God. And you are saying it is sweet sin, I love it, I like it, I enjoy it, who will take this away from my hand? That sweet sin will become a disempowering sin in your life. A shared sin. Adam and Eve sharing it together, and many people, men and women, sharing it together, boys and girls sharing it together. Give me part of it and I will take part of it. Shared sin becomes a deadly sin. In the day that you eat of that fruit, thou shalt surely die. And it became a deadly sin to them. That's why sin is evil. And that's why sin is not something you should delve into. And if you are there already, that's what brought the disconnection. And that's what brought disempowerment in your life. And today the Lord has to make the reconnection. Is going to take all the consequences of those sins away from your life in Jesus' name. A small sin. That's what I hear people saying. They say, this is small, this is small. I'm not going to commit murder. I'm not going to commit, highway robbery. I'm not going to commit, this great big sin. All I want to do is have this small sin. But you understand, Adam and Eve, you know what brought all that tragedy on them? What brought all the danger, devastation on them? You know what brought all the destruction on them? The small sin became dispossessing sin. It dispossessed them from the Garden of Eden and from all the good things that Lord had promised them and provided for them, and the supporting power and the sustaining power and the dominion they ought to have. They were dispossessed of them because the small sin became a dispossessing sin. Maybe you have some good things in your life, some good things going on for you. And when you are going with God, and when you love God, and when you're serving God, and when you say no to every temptation, and you say no to every sin, but as you come into a life of sinning, a life of disobedience, a life of rebellion, a life, the life of the world, love not the world, neither the things that are in the world. If any man love the world, the love of the Father is not in him. As you go into that and you do what the worldly people are doing, the small sin, a little thing here, a little thing there, becomes a dispossessing sin in your life. And the peace you enjoyed in the past, and the goodness you enjoyed in the past, and the favor of God you enjoyed in the past, and the presence of God you enjoyed in the past, all that now is gone. You are dispossessed of them. But thank God for another chance tonight. Somebody there, I say, thank God for another chance tonight. Because what we are dispossessed of in our disconnection, as we are reconnected with the Lord himself will bring all that you have lost, bring it back to your life in Jesus' name. You know, for Eve, it was a secret sin. And the serpent said, it's between you and I here. Even Adam is not overseeing you now. Why don't you do that thing and prove what I'm trying to tell you? And then she went into that secret sin. It became a damning sin. The things that people do in the secret, committing sin in the secret, God is everywhere. And he knows everyone, and he sees the heart of everyone, and he sees the actions of everyone. And that secret sin then damns the soul, that they are not able to be with the Lord. And the Lord signified that in driving them out of the Garden of Eden. But reconnection is possible today for you, for me, for everyone. As you come to the Lord, and you're not giving excuse like Adam and Eve gave excuse, and you said, yes, it was secret, but God knew it all. It was a damning sin, and the Lord will forgive, and the Lord will pardon. He'll take the damnation away, and forever you will ever be with the Lord in Jesus' name. It was a suggested sin. If you're a Christian already, you're born again already, and you have made your commitment to the Lord, your consecration to the Lord, that in the day and in the night, I will live for the glory of God. In the day, in the night, wherever I am, my hands, my feet, my mouth, my eyes, my ears, my thoughts, my brain, everything I have will be to the glory of God. That's the commitment, consecration you made. But now a suggestion is coming from a child of perdition, from a son of Satan, from the serpent who was working for Satan, and is suggesting, why don't you do it? There'll be nothing to it. It will make you better. It will make you richer. It will make you this and that. When you follow a suggested sin like that, it becomes a domineering sin. It will have domination upon your life. It will have such authority, and to not shake it off, it will be difficult. You can invite sin with one finger. The 10 fingers will not be able to push them away, because that suggested sin becomes a domineering sin. That's why the person in Romans chapter 7 cried out, and he said, "O wretched man that I am, who shall deliver me from this body of death, from this domineering sin? The things I don't want to do, that's what I do. And the things I want to do, that's what I'm not able to do." And he said, "If I do that which I don't want to do, and I cannot do that which I ought to do, it is no more I, but sin that dwelleth in me." It became a domineering sin. And the people who commit similar sins today, that they know the way of truth, they know the path of righteousness, and then the serpent comes, or the devil comes, or the neighbors come, or backsliders come, and they try to convince them, "Why do you think that is wrong? Why do you think we shouldn't do that? I've been doing it, and you know, everything appears all right." That's a liar. If you are sinning against God, everything is not all right. And you know that, and Satan knows that, and God knows that. He says, "I've been doing it, and everything is all right." And then, like the serpent beguiled Eve, and like Eve deceived and gave it to Adam, you now commit a similar sin. It becomes a disinheriting sin, that the Lord will say, "I disown them. I disinherit them. I thought I'll take them, the children of Israel, out into the land of Canaan before, but now that they're far away from me," because their similar sin became a disinheriting sin. But thank God tonight, there is solution. I say thank God tonight, there is solution. If you will take the solution, that solution will come to you tonight in Jesus' name. That leads me to point number three now. Point number three, the possibilities in a unique reconnection. Number one, connection. Number two, disconnection. Number three, reconnection. Tonight is the night of reconnection. Are you there? I said tonight is the night of reconnection. And as you are reconnected with the Lord tonight, forgiveness will come. Are you hear a good amen? As you are reconnected with the Lord tonight, healing will come. As you are reconnected with the Lord tonight, salvation will come. And as you are reconnected with the Lord tonight, you'll become an heir of God. That's heirship. Everything that God says he has provided for us through Christ on the cross of Calvary, you'll be an heir in Jesus' name. And now tonight, as you are reconnected with the Lord, there'll be a new name. God will give you a new name. You'll not be called a sinner anymore. You'll be a saint of God in Jesus' name. A new nature. The Lord will change your nature. And the nature that is bent on doing evil, the nature that is bent on committing sin and living in sin, the Lord turns you around. A new name, a new nature, a new nationality comes upon your life in Jesus' name. That means you are now of the nation of the godly. And then that new nationality, it's just like when somebody, for example, now is being an African, he relocates to America, and then he has the nationality of America. All the things that are provided for the citizens over there will be provided for him. And tonight, there's a change coming in your life. I said there's a change coming in your life. Forgiveness is coming. Healing is coming. Salvation is coming. And then a new life is coming. And then you'll be an heir of the Lord. Then the love of God will saturate your heart. And God will say, don't ever think I hate you. Don't ever think I'm bitter against you. All those things have passed under the bridge. I love you. And the love of God will make you who you ought to be in Jesus' name. And then deliverance. Somebody there, I said deliverance. And dominion. And then when he delivers you and he gives you dominion, he brings delegation. That means all that Christ was able to do as you believe on him, he delegates that into your hand. He says, go and talk like I talked. Go and live like I lived. Go and have answered prayer like I have answered prayer. And go and do everything I did, because he that believeth on me, the works I do, he shall do also. Who is that one? And this sign shall follow them that believe. Who is that one? In my name they lay hands on the sick and they shall recover. I said, who is that one? You'll be, number one, there's deliverance. Number two, there's dominion. And number three, there's delegation. And heaven will look at you as a man of authority, as a woman of authority. And things will totally change in your life in Jesus' name. And what Adam and Eve had originally in the original divine connection, what they had, the fullness of life, what they had, the goodness of life, what they had, all the favor that God showed them and the graciousness of life, you will have as you reconnect with the Lord even today in Jesus' name. You will reconnect. I said you will reconnect, and your life will never be the same in Jesus' name. Look at John chapter 10. I'm reading from verse 10. John chapter 10. We're looking at verse 10. The thief cometh not but for to steal and to kill and to destroy. That's what the serpent did. He saw that Adam and Eve were well connected to the Redeemer, well connected to the Creator, well connected to the God of heaven and earth, and things were going on well with them. And then he came so that
he will steal, he will kill, he will destroy. That's what brought the disconnection. But now Christ has come. The Savior has come. The Redeemer has come. The one to forgive all your sins, he has come. And the one to heal your body, he has come. And the one to give you super abundant living has now come. It's now in your hand. It's a unique reconnection as you receive him, as you accept him, and you say all that happened in the period of disconnection, I'm going to abandon everything and I come to the Lord. Grace will flow into your life. Mercy will flow into your life. Forgiveness will flow into your life. You will have the salvation of God from heaven in Jesus' name. The thief cometh not but to kill and to destroy. I am come. You'll have life. You'll have life. Where are you? You'll have life in Jesus' name. I am calm. That's why he came. He came to make reconnection with the everlasting God. And when he makes reconnection with the everlasting God, eternal life, everlasting life will come in your life in Jesus' name. I am calm that they may have that life. Let me read it. There, Christ has come that you may have life. That you may have life. That you may have life. And have it, tell me. And have it, tell me out aloud. If you want that tonight, it's available. Salvation available. Forgiveness available. Conversion available. Peace of heart available. And then healing for your body. He will so heal you and take away all those infirmities as Adam and Eve were before sin came in. Your blind eyes will open. Your deaf ears will open. The dumb tongues will speak freely. And the lame will rise up and walk. That cancer will vanish away. Tuberculosis will not remain there. You have life and you have it more abundantly. You will be made whole. You will be healthy. And everything that has come from Satan, the Lord will command Satan and go. And that thing will live your life in Jesus' name. A unique reconnection. Pick up your mind. That you are the one tonight, and as you reconnect with the Lord, everything will become all right in your life. All right in my life. Say it for yourself, all right in my life. He has come so that you will have life, and you'll have life more abundantly. Let's rise up now. It's time for you to reconnect. To reconnect. Time for you to reconnect. You are reconnecting right now. The devil came. He came to kill. He came to destroy. But Christ has come. The Savior has come. The Redeemer has come. That you will have life. The life of God in man. You will have life. That original life. When they had divine connection. The Lord has come. That you will have life. Tell the Lord. Don't give excuse like Adam and Eve. Don't give excuse like the people who are laying the blame of their sin on other people. Lord, I am the one. I am the one. I took that foolish step. I'm the one. I committed that single sin. I ate that sweet sin. I am the one. I took part in that shared sin. I'm the one. I thought it was a small sin, but now it has dispossessed me. I did that sin, but now it became a damning sin. It was suggested to me and I took it. And then I've committed a similar sin like Adam and Eve. Oh Lord, have mercy upon me. God will have mercy upon you. He's here to forgive you. He's not here to condemn you. He's not here to kill you. He's not here to you. He's here to show his love and to show his mercy and to give you forgiveness, redemption. Lord, I'm sorry. I turn away from my sin. Lord, I'm sorry. I repent. Now I receive Jesus as my personal Savior. Jesus is mine now. He came so that I will have life and I will have it more abundantly. I stand at the door and knock. If anyone hears my voice and opens the door, I will come in unto him. I will live with him and sup with him. And so that super life will begin through the divine connection. Don't hide. Lord, I'm sorry. If we confess our sin, he's just and faithful to forgive us and to cleanse us from all unrighteousness. He forgives and he sets you free. He comes to your life, grants you pardon, and then he'll grant you the peace of God. And the Spirit of God will bear witness in your heart that Christ has had mercy on you. Whosoever comes to me, I will in no wise cast out. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Everyone, in Jesus' name we pray. Amen. The Lord wants to reconnect everyone that has been disconnected by sin. And whosoever shall call on the name of the Lord shall be saved. There's no discrimination. Anywhere you are, you're in the regions, you're in the states, you're in the nations, anywhere, or you're online right there. The Lord is near you where you are. And as you have called upon the Lord, and you sincerely separate yourself, repent from the sins that brought disconnection, the mercy of God will come to you right now. The forgiveness of God will come to you right now. Salvation will be yours in Jesus' name. But it's a unique reconnection. Unique. That means you make up your mind. You're not looking here and there. You say, for me in particular, I make the reconnection now and I receive Jesus as my personal Savior. Heads bowed and eyes closed. You want to do that right now and you want to have this reconnection with the Almighty God through the Lord Jesus Christ, wherever you are, just raise up your hand. That all the sins that separated you from the Lord will forgive, the Lord will cancel, and then the peace of God will reign in your heart, anywhere you are, inside the church building, outside the church building, in the region, in the state, anywhere you are, online. Just tell the Lord now as you raise up your hand, and then you pray, you say, Lord, I turn away from my sin and I receive you now as my personal Savior. Don't mind if other people are not doing it, you in particular, it is unique with you. I receive the Lord as my personal Savior. And he makes the reconnection with the Heavenly Father now, and then you become a child of God. Keep up that hand as I pray for you. Father, in the mighty name of Jesus, according to your promise that whosoever comes to you through Christ, you will in no wise reject, I pray you receive all these people now in Jesus' name. And I pray forgiveness will be for every one of them without exception in Jesus' name. And I'm asking, Lord, that the Spirit of God will bear witness in their heart. Their sins are forgiven. Their sins are wiped away. And you have cleansed and washed them. And sin will not be their ruin anymore in Jesus' name. And give them the power and the grace to go and sin no more. New life, new name, new nature, new nationality, and a new creature. Make every one of them one by one in Jesus' name. And we pray that your Spirit will confirm that they are now children of God and you have set them free. Assure them, Lord, you have received them and you have written their name in the book of life in heaven. Confirm it for every repentant, believing sinner in Jesus' name. We thank you because we know it is done. In Jesus' name we pray. And the people of God shout, amen. Our counselors are there, workers, leaders, choir, ushers, they are there. Those who raised up their hand, they'll give you a card. And if you are online, you find a way of getting back to us. You've given your life to the Lord. Give your name and your number to the numbers you see on the screen. A change has come. And that change, that conversion will be permanent in Jesus' name. When we do this, I'll come back, and then the reconnection will bring the needed healing, deliverance, and miracle in every life in Jesus' name.
Counseling time. Let our counselors please be in touch with all who indicated. If you are yet to receive a slip from the counselor, please indicate, call the attention of the counselors so they can give you a slip to fill. We want the details to be accurately written so that we can be in touch with you and be of more help to you spiritually. So please, the rest of us, let's keep on praying. We are getting into the session of divine ministration, divine touch. As the man of God has told us, get prepared. The power of God will be touching you. Let's maintain the spirit of prayers. But for those who are have indicated giving their lives to Christ, please fill the slips that you are giving fully, accurately, legibly, so that we can be of help to you after this program. We'll be in a position to get in touch with you and to be of more help to you to grow spiritually. Let's quickly do this while we are waiting for the ministration of the power of God in the life of every one of us. Counselors, all workers, let's quickly get in touch with those who indicated giving their lives to Christ. Counselors, let's be fast about it. Let's know when you are done. Ground floor, first gallery and second gallery. In If you are yet to receive a slip from the counselors, please indicate. They have not reached you. You are giving your life to Christ. You want to be born again. But they have not reached you. Please indicate. Call the attention of the counselors around you so they can give you a slip to fill. Let's maintain the spirit of prayers as we are expecting great, great miracles from the Lord. Ground floor, are you done? First gallery. First gallery. Second gallery. Second gallery. Let's speed up, let's speed up. Our brethren online that have indicated giving their life to Christ, please check the details on the screen and respond accordingly so we can be in touch with you and be of help to you. Click on the link and fill in the form online. If you are online and you have giving your life to the Lord during this program after the ministration of the man of God, click the link, fill the form, submit online, so we can be of more spiritual help to you. Be expectant. Miracle on your way. Be expectant. God of miracle will touch you. Be expectant for divine connection.